Welcome everyone to Self Principle. As always, I'm Dr. Sean Hashmi. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, today's topic is the age-old question of what is the best time to exercise. Now, today's topic is about science. So we're going to look at the evidence behind it, not bro science, not somebody's opinion, but what does the research say? So let's go ahead and dive into the research and answer this question. Well, the first study we have here is a small one. It's a randomized crossover trial, 11 people with type 2 diabetes. Ages were about 45 to 68, BMI 23 to 33. And what they had these folks do was 2 weeks of high intensity training, either in the morning or in the afternoon, morning being about 8 a.m., afternoon being about 4 p.m. And then they gave them a 2 week washout period and they switched the group. What they found was that the group that exercised in the afternoon, they actually had decreased glucose concentrations or sugar concentrations compared to the morning one. So the afternoon group actually had an advantage for being able to get rid of sugar from the blood. Let's look at an even better study with more folks in there. This study had 32 males. These were at risk for type 2 diabetes, or they already had a diagnosis of type 2 diabetes. They did 12 weeks of supervised exercise training, either in the morning or the afternoon. What they found was that the afternoon group actually had better insulin sensitivity, they had better breakdown of fat, they had better fasting sugar levels, they even had better exercise performance, and they lost more fat overall as compared to the morning group. So once again, the afternoon group had advantages. Then let's look at a different study. In the last two studies we talked about, the problem with those studies is they didn't control for what they were eating. So in this particular study, they actually controlled the diet of all of the participants. This was a parallel group, which means they were all going at the same time. It was a randomized study with three groups. There was the morning exercise, there was the afternoon exercise, and then there's the control arm. They had 25 people total. They were either overweight or obese, and they were all fed a high-fat diet, meaning 65% of the calories came from fat for 11 days. So what did they find? Well, in the morning exercise group, as expected, their cardiorespiratory fitness increased, as did their increase in cardiorespiratory fitness in the evening group. But the evening group also had lower fasting insulin, lower insulin after meals. They had lower fasting sugars going on. They had lower sugars overnight or at nighttime, and they also had lower cholesterol floating around in their bloodstreams. So once again, we see not only better improvements in performance, in fat mass, in cholesterol, and in sugar uptake with exercising in the afternoon. Something interesting is when you eat a high-fat diet, you end up having increase of certain lipids, such as sphingolipids. Now, sphingolipids are linked with things like insulin resistance, linked with higher amounts of inflammatory cytokines, so you have more inflammation in the body going on. You even have fatty deposits that occur, and there's this dysregulated metabolism of fat that occurs. The beauty of exercise is that it actually reduces those sphingolipids circulating in the bloodstream, and evening exercise was better than morning exercise. So far we have looked at short-term studies, but what happens if we start to look at some longer-term data? So here we have a 12-week study in which we took 40 sedentary adults randomly assigned to either morning exercise or evening exercise. And the exercise was really just moderate intensity walking, and they also had four resistance type exercises along with that. And what they were looking for, once again, was sugars before the meal, after the meal, and things like A1C, which helps you to understand longer-term sugar over 3 months. And so what did they find when they looked at longer-term data? Turns out there wasn't any difference. So in terms of sugar, whether it was hemoglobin A1C or fasting sugars or postprandial or after-meal sugars, there was no statistical difference between morning or evening exercise. Well, that being the case, it makes it a little bit confusing. Which one should you do? So let's try to answer this question a different way. What is the easiest time to form a habit? So in this particular study, they had 48 students. They followed them for 90 days, and they were trying to adopt healthy behaviors, either trying to build those behaviors first thing in the morning or build them in the evening. And so what happened? As the researchers extrapolated out the results, they showed that the morning group actually formed the habit in about 105 days, but the evening group took them 154 days to form the same habit. So if you're looking to form habits, it turns out morning may be better. So taking all of this information together, what is the bottom line and what should you do? Well, first thing is there's probably some slight advantages to working out in the afternoon, but that's not how I like to look at it. I always tell all of my patients and all of the folks that I work with, whether back in the day when I was a personal trainer or now, is the best time to exercise is the one you can stick to. You want to focus on habits, not one-offs. And what the science shows is that morning exercise is easier to stick to than afternoon or evening exercise. Life happens as the day progresses. You want to show love to yourself first thing in the morning. And the best way to do that is through self. Sleep more, move more, practice gratitude and kindness, and eat a whole foods plant-based diet. And when you're looking at exercise, morning turns out to be a better option. Thanks so much for checking us out. As always, I'm Dr. Sean Hashmi with Self Principle, and I'll see you next time.